Okay. So chapter number 6 in class 12 is metallurgy, ma. Okay. So what is meant by metallurgy? The process of extracting metals from their respective ores is called as metallurgy. Clear, ma? So for example, if you take all the elements, you can divide them into how many types, ma? 3 types. What are they? Metals, metalloids, and non-metals. This is how you can divide all the elements, no? So all the elements in the periodic table, you can divide them into 3 types: metals, metalloids. Okay, ma. So see, ma, metals, depending upon their existence, can again be classified into 2 types. So pure metals and metals in the form of compounds, or you can say metals in combined state. Okay. So what are the pure metals which are available to us, ma? So the metals which are available in the nature, without any extraction process, we can get them. Okay. Example is, gold is a very good example, no, ma? Gold. So gold is naturally available in the earth. You need not refine this one, you need not extract this one from any other ore. Okay. Similarly, silver also, Argentina. Similarly, platinum also. Okay, ma? So these are the metals which are existing in pure form. Pure form means what? They are available in the nature as they are. You need not extract them from any other type of ores or minerals. Are you able to understand? Next, metals in combined state. And most of the metals we get only in combined state only. So example we write down. Okay, ma? What are the examples we will write? Cu2S. Okay. Al2O3. ZnS. PbS. Clear, ma? And NaCl, etc. Okay. So these are the some of the examples where metals are present in combined state. See, ma, copper is existing in nature in the form of Cu2S. Okay. And the name of this one is called copper glands. Copper glands. Okay. Aluminium will exist in the form of Al2O3 in nature, which is called as corundum. Okay. Zinc exists as ZnS, which is called as zinc blend. Okay, ma? PbS, plumbum. Plumbum is the Latin name of lead, no, ma? Lead exists in the nature as PbS. Okay. And the general name of this one is galena or jalena. Clear, ma? And sodium exists in the nature in the form of NaCl, which you can call it as rock salt. Okay. So these are the metals which exist, and there are many other forms, ma. Some of the examples I have written in. So these metals, they exist only in combined state. Okay. That is, from these respective minerals or ores, we have to extract these metals. Okay. But whereas gold, argentinum, that is silver, platinum, they exist naturally in the universe, naturally in the world. You need not do any process of extraction or concentration or refining. All this you need not. Are you able to understand? So therefore, out of all the metals, how many are all the elements, how many of them are metals, ma, in the periodic table? 80% of them elements are metals only, no? Okay. So 80% of elements are what? Metals in the periodic table. Clear, no? For example, if you take S block is totally made up of what? S block is totally made up of metals. Okay, ma? D block also metals only. F block also metals only. Clear, na, ma? Only in P block you will get metals, you will get non-metals. Okay, ma? And you will get metalloids also, semi-metals. Are you able to understand, ma? So definitely to obtain these metals which are not existing in the natural form, we need to do some extraction process, and that extraction process is exactly what is called as metallurgy, extracting of the metals from their respective ores. Okay. Now let us write some terms of metallurgy which we need to understand. Okay. Terms which we use in metallurgy. Okay. First one is terms in metallurgy. Okay. First one which we use is mineral. You should have studied about mineral, no? Now can you say what is meant by mineral? Mineral means what? Metal in combined form, or you can call it as in compound form. Metal in combined form, if it is present, then it is called a mineral. For example, if you take iron, there are many minerals of iron. Okay, iron, ferrum. If you take, one of the mineral is hematite. Okay, ma. And one more mineral is magnetite. One more mineral is limonite. Okay, ma. Iron pyrite, siderite. So these are some of the minerals of just iron itself. Okay. And their formulas are like this: hematite, Fe2O3, magnetite, Fe2O4, limonite, 2Fe2O3, 3H2O, clear nama? Iron pyrite, Fe2S, clear nama? FeS2, okay? Siderite, FeCO3. So these are the molecular formulas of these minerals. Are you able to understand, ma? So in all these minerals you can find iron, so that is why they are called as minerals. When metals, when they are present in combined state, then you can call them as minerals. Okay, so keep the next side heading, ores. What is meant by ore? Ore means what? Ore. Okay, ma. Ore is a mineral from which metal can be extracted profitably. This is called as a ore. Okay, ma. So there is a difference between mineral and a ore, ma. What is the difference? Difference between mineral and ore is what? Okay. See, ma, in a mineral, compounds are present, that's it. Iron is present in all these minerals, no? But what is meant by ore? Ore is also a mineral, but from this mineral, very easily you can extract that particular metal. And you have to extract that one profitably. That means in this extraction process, the efforts which you put should be very less, so that profit can be achieved. That is called as a mineral, ore. Are you able to understand, ma? See, ma, of all these minerals, only hematite is the ore of iron. What is the meaning of this? Hematite is the ore of iron means? So example, hematite. Hematite is ore of iron. What is the meaning of this one? It means only out of hematite only, very easily you can extract this iron. Okay, ma? And you can remove from iron pyrite also, but hematite is a very good ore. It means from hematite you can remove iron profitably, very easily you can remove. That is the meaning of it. Okay, ma? So next one is, so here there is one note point which you can write. One note point is that all ores are minerals. Okay, but all minerals are not ores. So this point also I can write. So every ore is a mineral only, every ore is a compound itself. But every mineral cannot behave as a ore, because from all these we can remove iron, but it may be profitable, it may not be profitable. So every mineral cannot behave like a ore, but every mineral is definitely a every ore is definitely a mineral. So these are the points which you should remember. Are you able to understand, ma? And one more terminology which we should remember is gang, ma. GANGUE, gang. Gang means what? Clear, ma? It is the impurity or impurities present in ores or minerals. This is called as gang. For example, if you take hematite, which exists in natural form in the world, it is not a purely hematite, no, ma? So some sand will be mixed with that one, some soil will be mixed with that one. So all the impurities which are present in a ore is called as gang. Are you able to understand? So these are the three terminologies minimum we have to remember in the case of metallurgy. Okay. ప్రతి దాంట్లో ఇంప్యూరిటీ ఉంటుంది. మనకు మినరల్స్తో పని లేదన్నమాట. మనకు పని దేంతో ఉంది? ఓర్స్తోనే పని ఉంది. దాన్ని కూడా గ్యాంగ్ అని అంటాం. క్లియర్మా? ఓకే. సో నెక్స్ట్ రైట్ డౌన్ ద స్టెప్స్ ఫాలోడ్ ఇన్ మెటలర్జీ, దట్ ఈస్ ఎక్స్ట్రాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ మెటల్స్. ఓకేమా? సో స్టెప్స్ ఫాలోడ్ ఇన్ ఎక్స్ట్రాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ మెటల్స్ ఆర్ metallurgy. Okay, ma? So these three names you can remember like this, ma. CRR. Okay. C for concentration of ore. Okay, ma? R for reduction of ore. And R for refining of ore. Okay, ma? So these are the three steps by which we can extract metals from this particular ore. Are you able to understand? First one is concentration of ore, reduction of ore, and the third one is refining of ore. Okay. So we will study about the first one, which is called as concentration of ore. Okay. So concentration of ore is also called as ore dressing, or you can call it as dressing of ore. Or also you can call it as benefaction also. Benefaction. Okay, ma? So here the undesirable impurities are being removed. Impurities are removed. So that is what we do in the case of concentration of ore. So what are the quantities which we doesn't require, they are removed from this process of concentration of ore. Clear, no, ma? And this concentration of ore can be performed in four different methods, ma. Okay. So we will discuss those methods in detail. So concentration of ore can be done in four methods. Okay. So first one is called as hydraulic washing. Okay, ma? Second one is called as froth, flotation. Okay, ma? Third one is called as electromagnetic separation. Okay. Third one, and the fourth one is called as leaching. Okay, ma? So these are the four methods by which we can concentrate a ore. What is meant by concentration? Already we have studied, no, ma? Removal of gang or impurities from a particular ore is called as concentration of ore. Are you able to understand?
Sir,
right. Okay, nimisham, right. Okay, ma? Now see. So therefore, the first method of concentration which we are using is hydraulic washing. Okay. So by this method, only heavy metals can be concentrated. Heavy metals, the metals whose molecular mass is very large, only those metals can be concentrated. For example, tin, iron, plumbum, so this type of metals can be concentrated. So what is the concept that I have represented in this diagram? We can understand very easily here. See, ma. Through this tube, ore is made in powder form and it is passed through this tube. Okay, ma? we take the powdered form of this ore and it is passed through this tube. Are you able to understand? And where this ore is passing here, we place a jet of water, water which is traveling with a very high speed. Okay, so this water gets into contact with this ore which is in powder form, and all the impurities, the gang which is present in this ore, that will be flown away with water. Okay, ma? Because comparatively gang will be lighter, no, when compared to ore. So we are discussing about which kind of metals, heavy metals. Okay, ma? Water is very lighter when compared to metals. So this gang or the impurities which are present in this ore, they are flown away with respect to water. Water takes away all the dust particles, the soil impurities, the sand, the silica, whatever it present, this water will take away. And the remaining ore which is in concentrated form, that will form into our container. Are you able to understand? So this process of refining is called as hydraulic washing. And which are the important points here? Point is that these metals, these are the examples which can be asked in the examination. Okay, ma? Tin, stannum, Fe iron, Pb plumbum, lead. So these are the metals which can be concentrated with the help of hydraulic washing. Are you able to understand? That's what we are discussing here. Okay, ma? When we place a jet of water, this jet of water, it will take what? It will take only lighter particles. These metals, they are very heavy metals, no, ma? Iron, plumbum, tin, they are very heavy metals. So they cannot flow away with water because their density is very large. Okay, so even water is flowing, only what you call this gang only will flow, but remaining metal or ore will be collected in the downwards. So that is how we set the speed of this water. Are you able to understand, ma? That's it. So the second method of concentration is called as froth flotation, ma. Okay. So very, very important concept, ma. From these questions, in every 2 years, one question was asked from froth flotation. Okay. So froth flotation. Okay. So for which ores we use froth flotation, that is very important. Okay, ma? We use this method for sulfide ores of copper, zinc, lead and iron. Okay, ma? So for sulfide ores of this copper, zinc, plumbum and iron, we use this method of concentration which is called as froth flotation. Are you able to understand, ma? So what are the ores we use here? Ores used are ores in which we use this method of concentration are, okay, ma? So first one, Cu2S. So this is concentrated by using froth flotation. So this is sulfide ion of copper only, no? Cu2S. Clear, no, ma? This is also called copper glands. Okay. So this copper glands is concentrated with the help of froth flotation. Okay. Similarly, PbS. Similarly, ZnS. Similarly, FeS2. Okay, ma? So all of them you have sulfur here. Sulfur ion is present, no? So that is why all the sulfide ions of these respective metals, they are concentrated by using this method which is called as froth flotation. Clear, no, ma? So ZnS is called what? This is called zinc blend. Okay, ma? PbS is called galena or jalena. FeS2 is called iron pyrite. Okay? So these ores, they are concentrated with froth flotation. Now let us see what is the actual process of doing this froth flotation. Okay, ma? Froth means what, ma? Froth means you can call them as bubbles which are floating on the surface of water. Okay, ma? Nuraga antam chudandi, nuraga. That is called as froth. So with the help of these bubbles which are floating on the surface of water, we try to concentrate these ores. Okay? Now let us see what is the working of this method, ma? Here, so ore in powder form is put in a beaker of water. water. Pine oil or eucalyptus oil. Pine oil or eucalyptus oil is poured for producing float. Okay, ma'am? Then air is blown into the container. Air is blown into the container to produce froth. Okay, ma? So here what I write, the ore placed wets with froth. Pine oil and reaches the top. Okay, ma? Gang wets with water and reaches the bottom of container. Okay, so this is the method by which we do the process of froth flotation. Are you able to understand? So what is the technique here? We are using, we are taking a container of water and we are pouring some pine oil or eucalyptus oil. So these oils, they have the ability to produce this froth. Bubbles in produce this ability oils. Are you able to understand? Then we are pouring this ore in powder form. Whatever ore I want to concentrate, that I am pouring in powder form. Then I am blowing air into this one. If I blow air into this container containing this pine oil, what happens? Immediately bubbles will form, no? Are you able to understand, ma? And this ore, it wets with pine oil or eucalyptus oil only, ma? Are you able to understand? What are the different ores we are taking? These are the ores which are taking, no, ma? These ores, they get wet with pine oil and they doesn't get wet with water. Water lo tadavavavi. Dentlo tadustai. They get wet in either pine oil or eucalyptus oil only. Are you able to understand? And when they get wet with this pine oil, we start producing bubbles. And bubbles are lighter when compared to water, number. So these bubbles, they come and settle at the top. Then what about the gang or impurities or soil or silica which is present in these ores? They get wet with water and they go to the bottom of the container. So very easily we can separate the required minerals or we can concentrate these ores by using this method of froth flotation. Are you able to understand what is happening? So which gets wet with pine oil, ma? Ore will get wet with pine oil and a gang will get wet with water and it reaches to the bottom of the container. That's it. Clear, no? But in this froth flotation, to enhance this concentration, we use some chemicals, ma. What are the chemicals we use? We will write here. Okay, ma? So first of all I will use froth collector. Okay, ma? Froth collector. So example of froth collector is potassium, ethyl, xanthanate. Okay, so this chemical is used as froth collector. Potassium, ethyl, xanthanate. Okay, and what is the function of this froth collector? This enhances the wettability of ore in pine oil. Are you able to understand, ma? So what is the function of froth collector, ma? It will make the ore to get wet with pine oil very easily. That is the function of this froth collector. Okay, ore should be wet with pine oil, ma? Then bubbles can be produced, then they can be collected at the top. So this enhances the nature of wetting nature of this ores with respect to pine oil, so that most of the ore is mixed with pine oil and it can be collected at the top. That is the function of this froth collector. Okay, ma? Then we use another chemical which is called as froth stabilizer. Okay, ma? Froth stabilizer. So examples of froth stabilizers are aniline, Cresol. These are the examples of froth stabilizers. Clear? So their shape appears a bit like this. Okay, ma? And this is Cresol. Okay, ma? So these are the molecular structures which are added to this container as froth stabilizers. And what is the function of froth stabilizers? We will write here. Okay, ma? So this froth stabilizer These stabilizers maintain the froth. Okay, ma? So that bubbles live long and can be collected easily. Okay, ma? So that is the function of this froth stabilizers like aniline and Cresol. Okay, so can you say what is the meaning of the statement which I have written, ma? Froth stabilizer means what? They will maintain the froth for a long time. Nodagani ekku sep alage unchataniki help avutai. Are you able to understand? So if froth disintegrates, again ore will go to the bottom of the container. So to maintain the froth, we use these two chemicals, aniline as well as Cresol. Are you able to understand, ma? Then one more chemical which we use in froth flotation is depressant. Okay. So what is the function of this depressant? This is used, okay, ma, when mixture of ore is present and we need only one ore. Are you able to understand? So in which condition depressant is used? Depressant is used when a mixture of ore is present and out of that mixture I want only one ore. Are you able to vintanara rastanara meer intaku వింటు రాసేంత సీన్ మీకు ఉందని నేను అనుకోవడం లేదు. వింటా ఉన్నారా రాస్తా ఉన్నారు ఇంతకు రెండు చేస్తూ ఉన్నారు. ఓకే సీమా. సో డిప్రెసెంట్ మీన్స్ వాట్? ఎ మిక్స్చర్ ఆఫ్ టూ ఓర్స్ ఆర్ ప్రెసెంట్ అండ్ ఐ వాంట్ టు సపరేట్ ఓన్లీ వన్ ఓర్. ఐ రిక్వైర్ ఓన్లీ వన్ ఓర్. దెన్ ఇన్ దట్ కండిషన్ వి యూస్ దిస్ డిప్రెసెంట్ ఇన్ ద కేస్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రోత్ ఫ్లోటేషన్. సీమా, ఆల్ దిస్ వీఆర్ స్టడింగ్ అండర్ ఫ్రోత్ ఫ్లోటేషన్ ఓన్లీ. డోంట్ బి కన్ఫ్యూజ్డ్. క్లియర్? ఓకే. సో ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ డిప్రెసెంట్ ఆర్ okay ma, examples are NaCN, sodium cyanide, and Na2CO3, sodium carbonate. So these are the two examples which can be used as depressant. Are you able to understand, ma? So for example, let us consider we have a mixture of okay ma, so example we are writing now, we have a mixture of PbS and ZnS. Okay ma, we have a mixture of PbS and ZnS. So out of these two I want to get, okay ma, so Siva, we have a mixture of PbS and ZnS. Clear now? So to this container we add NaCN, sodium cyanide. Are you able to understand, ma? So therefore what happens? PbS plus NaCN, no reaction. It means galena doesn't react with sodium cyanide. PbS doesn't react with sodium cyanide. Clear, no? Whereas this ZnS, it reacts with NaCN, okay, ma, to form Na2ZnCN4. Okay. So this is the compound which is formed when ZnS reacts with NaCl. And what is the name of this one? This is called as sodium tetracyanozincate. Are you able to understand? So PbS doesn't react with NaCl, whereas ZnS reacts with NaCl. So very easily they can separate, they can be separated if one reaction happens and another reaction doesn't happen. Are you able to understand, ma? So this is the type of concentration which is called as froth flotation. Are you able to understand, ma? So in this froth flotation, what are the extra compounds we are studying? We are studying froth collector, froth stabilizer, and we are studying depressant. So these are the terms which you should remember. Okay. So after that, the third type of concentration of 4 is called as electromagnetic separation. Okay, ma? Third type of concentration which we are studying is electromagnetic separation. Okay, ma? So let us see what we do in this electromagnetic separation, ma. So here, ores of magnetic nature are separated. Okay, ma? So electromagnetic separation, the name itself indicates, no? Which ores can be separated here? The ores which has magnetic properties. These ores can be separated. Okay, ma? Example of them is wolframite, tungsten, okay, ma? Magnetite. Okay. So these type of force can be separated by this method which is called as electromagnetic separation. Now let us see what is the technique we use for separating the ore and the gang by using this method of electromagnetic separation. Okay, ma? So here also we do, okay, ma? We take ore in powdered form, ma. We take the ore in powdered form and put on a belt, conveyor belt. Okay. So, two collector bins, one magnetic and the other non-magnetic are placed below the belt. Okay, ma? So what we do, we take the powder form of this ore and we put it on a conveyor belt. What is meant by conveyor belt? In factories you should have seen, ma? Belts will be moving. Okay? On that some bags of cement, bags of sand, anything can be put, and these bags will be continuously rotating and they will be loading or unloading the lorries. Conveyor belts you should have seen. So like this here, this ore is taken in powdered form and put on a conveyor belt. Clear? Okay, ma? So this is a conveyor belt, ma, on which ore in powder form. Okay, ma? Ore is continuously passed onto the conveyor belt and belt starts moving in this particular direction, rotating continuously. Then we place two bins, ma, two collectors we place. So this is one collector and this is another collector. So this one is non-magnetic. Okay, ma? And this is a magnetic collector. Okay. Now if I do the arrangement like this, can you say what happens? We are not discussing about metals, whether they are heavy or non-heavy. We are discussing about magnetic property is present or not. Are you able to understand, ma? So all the gang, all the dust particle, all the soil, it will be collected in this non-magnetic dustbin. Are you able to understand, ma? And the magnetic properties of ore, they are attracted by this magnetic collector, no? And those magnetic ores, they will be collected in this, what you call magnetic collector. Very simple. Okay? So this is the type of separation which we used in the case of the third type of concentration, which is called as separation with the help of electromagnetic separation. Are you able to understand? Okay. All complex compounds are dissolvable in water. Are you able to understand, ma? So all the complex compounds, they are very much dissolvable in water. Are you able to understand? So So the next method of concentration of ore is leaching. Duster lakunda modalu pettanu raavano. Okay. See, ma, previously we studied three methods of concentration, no? What are the three methods we studied previously? First one is hydraulic washing. Okay, ma? Second one is froth, flotation. Third one is electromagnetic separation. This is what we studied in the last class, no? And what is the fourth method of concentrating ore? Fourth method is the leaching process. Are you able to understand, ma? So, right on. This process is used when metal is more soluble when compared to impurities. Are you able to understand, ma? So these bits can be asked in the examination, ma. So from this topic you will get only theory bits only, ma. Theory bits tappa inkem raavu. So attention to every detail is very, very important. So listen carefully. So leaching is what kind of process, ma? Is it a concentration process? Is it a reduction process? Is it a refining process? What kind of process is this? Concentration of ore only, no? Are you able to understand, ma? So previously we studied these three methods, and now we are studying the fourth one, leaching of ore. So all of them, they belong to the concentration of the ore itself. Are you able to understand? Now, leaching process we use in which condition? Leaching process we use when metal is more soluble when compared to impurities. Are you able to understand, ma? Metal dissolves very easily when compared to impurities. In this condition, we use the process of leaching. Okay? So by this process, which metals can be concentrated? Okay, ma? Metals, first one, aluminium, second one, gold or silver, can be concentrated. Are you able to understand? Okay. So by using leaching process, what are the metals which can be concentrated, ma? Aluminium, and the second one is silver or gold. Both of them, they can be concentrated. Are you able to understand? So bits can be asked on these metals also. Aluminium can be concentrated by how many methods? So like these questions can be asked. Are you able to understand? So see the metals which we are concentrating in different processes. That also you should have a clear cut idea. Okay. Now if I study about leaching of aluminium. Okay, ma? Leaching of aluminium. Okay, first of all, let us discuss aluminium has how many types of minerals, ma? Previously we studied about iron, no? Iron has many types of minerals, no, ma? Hematite, magnetite, all this we have studied, no? Similarly, aluminium also has some minerals, ma. What are they? Alumina. It is Al2O3. Okay, ma? So this is one mineral of aluminium. Are you able to understand? Clear? So next I can write Al2O3H2O, which is called as diaspore. This is another mineral of aluminium. Clear, Nama? Similarly, I can write bauxite, which can be written as Al2O3 2H2O. So this is also a mineral of aluminium. Are you able to understand, Ma? Similarly, I can write gibbsite, which is Al2O3 3H2O. Okay, Ma? So this is also a mineral of aluminium. Are you able to understand? And one more thing I can write, cryolite. So this is also a mineral of aluminium. And what is its formula? Na3AlF6. Are you able to understand? So these are the different minerals of aluminium. Okay. So what are all these? These are minerals of aluminium. Okay. So mineral is a different thing. Ore is a different thing, Noma. In the first class we discussed, no? So what is the difference between mineral and ore? Mineral ki ore ki difference emi? Okay. Mineral is just a compound, Ma, that's it. Compound in which aluminium is present, this is called as a mineral. But what is meant by ore? Ore means, so from these minerals, if you are able to extract a metal profitably, then it is called as ore. This is what we discussed in the last class, no? From the mineral, if you are able to extract that metal profitably, so that you can produce profit, then it is called as ore. So how many minerals we have written? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 minerals we have written, Nama. So out of all of them, only bauxite is the ore of aluminium. Which one is the ore of aluminium, Ma? Bauxite is the ore of aluminium. Are you able to understand? So write down. So out of all these minerals, bauxite is the ore of aluminium. Are you able to understand? Okay. And this bauxite, I can divide this one into two types of. So first one is called as red bauxite, and one more type is called as white bauxite. Are you able to understand, Ma? Red bauxite and white bauxite. So why it is red in color? Because here Fe2O3 will be the impurity. Okay, Ma? Which is the impurity which is present in red bauxite, Ma? Fe2O3 will be the impurity. That is why it is in red in color. Are you able to understand? Similarly, if you take white bauxite, silica is the impurity. Or I can write SiO2 is the impurity in white bauxite. Okay. So red bauxite can be leached by first one, Bayer's process. Okay, Ma? Second one is Hall's process. Is it clear, Ma? So I can concentrate aluminium or ore of aluminium by using how many processes? By using Bayer's process and Hall's process. So these are the two processes I will use for red bauxite, Ma. So be careful about each and every detail while you are studying. Are you able to understand? And white bauxite can be leached by Serpex process. So what is the name of the process we give to this one? It is called as Serpex process. Okay, Ma? So red bauxite is leached by Bayer's process and Hall's process, whereas white bauxite is leached by Serpex process. Are you able to understand, Ma? And here we are studying what? We are studying leaching process, Ma. Leaching is what kind of method? Leaching is a concentration method. Okay? Concentration method means already we have studied, Ma. Just removing of gang from the ore is called as concentration. Removing of impurities from the ore is called as concentration of a ore. Okay? So we will study the first process, which is called as Bayer's process. Okay, Ma? So write down. First process of leaching aluminium is called as Bayer's process. Okay. And what is meant by leaching? Already we have studied now. When metal is more soluble when compared to impurities, then it is called as leaching process. Are you able to understand? So in every leaching process, there will be a solvent which dissolves this metal. Are you able to understand? So this I can call it as a leaching agent also. Okay. So here, the leaching agent is leaching agent, or you can call it as solvent. Okay, ma? Leaching agent is caustic soda. Okay? NaOH. So caustic soda is the leaching agent in the case of which process? In the case of Bayer's process. Okay? So therefore, I will take this bauxite. Al2O3XH2O. Clear, no, ma? And it is reacted with caustic soda. Then I will form a complex molecule which is called as NaAlOH4. This is the molecule which is formed. Are you able to understand, ma? And this process is called as dissolution process. Are you able to understand, ma? So names of these processes also you should remember, ma. So when bauxite, when it is made to react with the leaching agent NaOH, and when this molecule is formed, which is a complex molecule which is soluble in water, then what is this process called? This process is called as dissolution process. Are you able to understand? And what is this NaLOH to the power 4, AH4? This can be called as sodium tetrahydroxy aluminate. Okay, ma? So this is the compound which is formed, and this is a complex compound. Complex compound. Okay? And here you make a note point. Now see. So first step is completed. No, this is called as a dissolution process. When this bauxite, when it reacts with the leaching agent, so this is the compound which is formed. Are you able to understand? And in red bauxite, this is which kind of bauxite, ma? We are studying about red bauxite only, no? And in red bauxite, which is the impurity which is present? Fe2O3, iron compound will be the impurity. Are you able to understand? So this Fe2O3, it reacts with SiO2 to form FeSiO3. Are you able to understand, ma? This one is called as impurity. This one is called as flux. And this one is called as slag. So these names also you are supposed to remember. Are you able to understand, ma? So the impurity present in red bauxite, flux. What is meant by flux? This flux goes and attaches with the impurity. Impurity in by pattukuntund anamata. Then all that product is removed as slag out of this concentration process. So this is the cleaning process here. Are you able to understand? So what is meant by flux? You write down. Flux. It attaches with impurity. Okay, ma? And what is meant by slag? Final impurity which is removed. Are you able to understand, ma? So this is the cleaning process which happens in the process of leaching, in the case of Bayer's process. Are you able to understand, ma? Now, I will take this compound here. So, NaAlOH4, are you able to understand, ma? And I made it to react with CO2 gas, which is an acidic gas. CO2 is what kind of gas, ma? It is an acidic gas. Okay? Then what happens is, again I will get Al2O3XH2O plus sodium carbonate, Na2CO3. So these are the compounds which will be formed once again. Are you able to understand, ma? So we are starting with Al2O3XH2O, and finally also we are getting Al2O3XH2O. But in the meanwhile process, the impurity has been removed from this ore. Are you able to understand, ma? And this step, we can call it as neutralization step. Neutralization process. Are you able to understand, ma? The second step which is involved in Bayer's process. What was the first one? First one was a dissolution. Now the second one is called as neutralization. Okay. So after neutralization, again what I do is, then I will start heating this compound which I got. So Al2O3 XH2O. Okay, ma? So I will start heating this one. Then what I will get? I will get Al2O3 and XH2O. It may be converted into vapor form. Are you able to understand? And this step is called as calcination. Okay, ma? So this is the third step which is involved in the case of Bayer's process. Are you able to understand, ma? So how many steps totally? Dissolution, neutralization, and the third one is calcination. In calcination, wherever you get this name, always we heat the compound, that's it. Are you able to understand? Just we heat the compound so that water gets separated from this compound. So these are the steps which are involved in Bayer's process. Okay? Right. MAC. MAC, MAC. Clear, Nama? So then we are studying about leaching of gold and silver. Okay? So this leaching of gold and silver is given the name MacArthur Forest Cyanide process. This is the name of this process. Are you able to understand, ma? So here, what are the leaching agents? Here, leaching agents are, okay, ma? NaCN and KCN. So these are the leaching agents which we use in MacArthur Forest Cyanide process. Are you able to understand, ma? So in this process, what we do, we take this compound Ag2S. Are you able to understand, ma? In which silver is present, and to this one we add this leaching agent which is called as NaCN. Then the compound which we get is, again we get a complex compound, ma, and the name of the compound is NaAgCN2. This is the compound which we will get. Are you able to understand? And the name of this compound is sodium argentocyanide. Okay, ma? So this is the compound which we get when I add this leaching agent to Ag2S. Are you able to understand? Then what we do is, this NaAgCN2, in the presence of zinc, it gets converted into Ag plus NaZnCN2. So this is the compound which will be formed. Are you able to understand, ma? So here what is happening, just in the place of silver Ag, here Zn is being substituted. Are you able to understand? Here we have Ag, no? And here I have zinc, that's all. So silver gets separated. Okay? But in this process, the silver obtained is not pure, ma, and it requires further refining. Okay, so write down. So silver obtained in this process is not pure and requires further refining. Zinc to react chestam manam in the presence of zinc. So here we have to write zinc. Are you able to understand, ma? So in the presence of zinc, these are the compounds which are formed. Are you able to understand? Right. Okay, ma? So the next process which we are studying is Serpex process, ma. And Serpex process is the process of refining what, ma? Chudandi. White bauxite. Okay, ma? So for concentrating white bauxite or leaching white bauxite, we use this method of Serpex process. Okay? So in this Serpex process, what are the leaching agents, ma? Carbon and nitrogen, they are the leaching agents. Are you able to understand? So we take this Al2O3 and made it react with 3C and nitrogen. Then these are the compounds which are formed, AlN and 3CO, carbon monoxide. Clear, nama? And what is this AlN? This is called as aluminium nitride. Then we take this AlN and we made it to react with water. Then the complex which is formed is AlOH taken thrice, which is also called as aluminium hydroxide. Are you able to understand, ma? So and this aluminium hydroxide, okay ma, we just heat this one. If I heat this one, then I will form again Al2O3. So this is the compound which is formed. Are you able to understand ma? And water gets separated. So in this process, we concentrate this aluminium by using this process of Serpex process. Are you able to understand? Okay. So make a note up to here. Completed na ma? Oh, continue chadama. So therefore, now we have completed all the four processes of concentrating. We have completed all the four processes of concentrating the ore, ma. So now what is the next step in extracting of metal, ma? See the notes. What is the next step? So three steps we have studied, no? First one is concentration of ore. Second one is reduction, and the third one is refining of ore. These are the three steps we have studied, no? So we have completed this one, which is called as concentration, ma, which consists of four steps. Okay, now we are going to the next process, which is called as reduction of ore. Okay, ma. So in this reduction of ore, what we do in this reduction of ore, we convert or we reduce metallic ores. We reduce metallic ores into metal oxides, metal oxides and metals. Are you able to understand? So this is what we do in the case of reduction. In a concentration of ore, what we have done in concentration of ore, just we have removed the impurities, no? Now actually we are trying to get the metals from this second process, which is called as reduction. Okay, ma? So we convert the metallic ores into metallic oxides, or also you can directly convert them into metals also. Okay, ma? And this reduction of ore, it can be divided into three steps, ma. Okay, three steps. First one is called as roasting. These are not steps, ma. Three types of reduction. So write down. So there are three types of reducing the ores. Okay. First one is called roasting. Second one is called as calcination. And the third one is called as smelting. Okay, ma? So these are the three methods of reducing the ore. Okay. So in roasting, what we do in roasting, we convert sulfide ores into metal oxides. Okay, ma? So for converting sulfide ores into metal oxides, we use the processing called as roasting. Okay, ma? And calcination. The second method of reducing is what? Calcination. And we use this calcination to convert to reduce hydroxide ores and carbonate ores into metal oxides. Okay, ma? So roasting is done in the presence of oxygen. Okay, ma? Here O2 is not required, and in smelting O2 is required. Are you able to understand? So in roasting, what we do, we try to convert sulfide ores. For example, we have PbS, ZnS, this kind of metal ores are there, no ma? Okay. So to convert them into metal oxides, the process which we use is called as roasting. Okay. And what is the second method here? Hydroxide ores. Hydroxide ores means what? Where water is present. Are you able to understand, ma? So these ores and carbonate ores. What is meant by carbonate ores? CaCO3 is an example of a carbonate ore, no? Calcium carbonate. So these type of ores, they are converted into metal oxides. In which process? In the process of calcination. Okay. And in the case of smelting, smelting what we do is here, metal oxides, okay ma, they are converted into metals. Or they are reduced into metals ma. Converted is not a good word. Metal oxides are reduced into metals. Okay. So now we are going to study each of these processes in detail. See ma. So the first process of reduction is called as roasting. See ma, in roasting already we have studied, no? Sulfide ores, they are converted into metal oxides. So this is done with what kind of furnace? This is done in a furnace called reverberatory furnace. And what is the melting point we maintain? Melting point is kept below the melting point of the metal. Are you able to understand? So this roasting is done in the presence of oxygen, no? So this is the reaction which forms here. So ZnS reacts with oxygen to form ZnO and SO2. Okay, so SO2 becomes a vapor and it is released out of the furnace. So what does this upwards arrow indicate? So this converts into gas, sulfur dioxide gas, and it escapes into the atmosphere. That is the meaning of it. Are you able to understand? Similarly, in a roasting process, we have another process which is called as self-reduction. Self-reduction in roasting. Okay, ma? Self-reduction in roasting. It means that the ore reacts with itself to form its oxide. Are you able to understand, ma? Let us see an example here. For example, Cu2S plus oxygen. It reacts with what? It bonds Cu2O and SO2 gas. This is what is formed. Are you able to understand, ma? So copper sulfate in the presence of oxygen, it converts into Cu2O and SO2 gas is released. Okay? And this Cu2O, it reacts with Cu2S again. Are you able to understand, ma? So Cu2O is formed initially. This again reacts with the own ore which is present. Are you able to understand? So therefore, what happens here? What is the reaction I can write? Cu2O plus Cu2S, they react to form copper and SO2 gas. Okay, ma? So this type of reduction we can call it as self-reduction in the case of roasting. Arthamavutunda em jarugutundo? See ma, Cu2S reacts with oxygen to form Cu2O. So Cu2O is, some amount of Cu2O is formed, no? This Cu2O again reacts with the Cu2S itself. Are you able to understand? It means the compound which is formed, that is reacting with its own ore. Then this is the compound which is formed. Copper, and what does this downward arrow indicate, ma? Precipitate. Copper settles as a precipitate and sulfur dioxide gas is released into the atmosphere. Are you able to understand? Let us write one more example. One more example which I can write is HGS, mercury sulfate. Are you able to understand, ma? So this reacts with oxygen to form HGO and SO2 gas. Are you able to understand? Now can you say what can be the next reaction? So HGO reacts with HGS to form HG and again SO2 gas. So this is the reaction which can happen. Are you able to understand? One more example is zinc sulfate, Zn2. Okay, ma? ZnS reacts with oxygen to form ZnO plus SO2 gas. Clear, ma? So this ZnO reacts with ZnS to form Zn and again SO2 gas. So these are some of the examples in which the process of self-reduction happens in the case of roasting process. Are you able to understand? Okay, see ma. So the second method of roasting is, reduction is what? Calcination. So what is meant by calcination, ma? Calcination already we have studied, no? So wherever you find water and wherever you find this carbonate ores, they are reduced into their metal oxides. Are you able to understand? Example is CaCO3. Calcination means just heating, no? Already I said, you know, calcination means what? Just heating of the ore, that's it. So it converts into CaO plus CO2. Are you able to understand? And some more examples, if I want to write FeCO3, Fe2CO3, clear, no? It converts into FeO and CO2. Clear? Next, PbCO3, when it is heated, it converts into PbO and CO2 gas. Okay? Similarly, Al2O3 XH2O, when it is heated, it converts into Al2O3 and XH2O. Are you able to understand, ma? Similarly, I can also write CaCO3, MgCO3, when it is heated, it converts into CaO plus MgO plus CO2 gas. So CaCO3, MgCO3, you should have studied in 10th class, no? This is called as a dolomite. Okay? So this is the process which is called as calcination process. Are you able to understand? So what we are doing, just we are heating the ore, that's it. And these ores, they are converting into their respective metallic oxides. Okay? So CaCO3. See, ma, and here what are the examples I have written? These examples you should see very carefully. Okay? Because question can be asked on which metal is reduced by using which process. These questions will be repeated. Okay? So see the examples very carefully and you are supposed to understand these examples. Okay? So CaCO3, FeCO3, PbCO3, Al2O3, XH2O and CaCO3, MgCO3, which is also called as dolomite. Okay? That's it. Okay, see, ma'am. So the next process which we are studying is smelting, ma'am. What is the use of smelting? Already we have studied, no? Use of smelting is to convert metallic oxides into their respective metals. Okay? And here, what are the reducing agents which we use in smelting? The reducing agents are these: carbon, carbon monoxide, aluminium. So these are the three reducing agents which we use in this process of smelting. Okay, and CO means, don't be confused with the cobalt, ma. This is carbon monoxide. Okay, so carbon, carbon monoxide, aluminium. So these are the three things by which we can reduce the agents. Clear? Sima. Examples are, these are the two examples which we use in smelting with the help of carbon. So ZnO reacts with carbon to form Zn and carbon monoxide gas. Clear, no? Similarly, SnO2 reacts with the carbon to form Sn and carbon monoxide gas. Are you able to understand? And then if I study smelting with respect to aluminium, smelting with the help of aluminium. So what is aluminium? Reducing agent. Are you able to understand, ma? So smelting, if I study with respect to aluminium as the reducing agent, then what is the name given to that particular reaction, ma? It is called as Goldsmith thermo-aluminate process. Are you able to understand? So by this process, what are the metals which can be reduced? Manganese, chromium, iron, silicon. Very, 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 very important bit, ma. Okay? So these are the metals which can be reduced by using which method? By using the method of smelting. Are you able to understand? Let us see some examples here. Okay? So Cr2O3, it reacts with aluminium to form chromium and Al2O3. Are you able to understand, ma? So here what is happening? The oxide of chromium reacting with aluminium to form chromium, and alumina is also formed. Al2O3 is called alumina, no? So alumina is also formed. And what is the importance of this alumina? This is a very hard metal. Very hard material. Okay? Al2O3 is a very, very hard material. And because it is so hard, it is used in, okay, ma? So aluminothermite welding. It is used in aluminothermite welding. Okay? For example, to weld two rails of a track, we use this process of welding, which is called as aluminothermite process. Okay, ma, welding process jarugutundi kada, there we use this metal Al2O3. Okay, and some more examples I can write. Mn3O4 reacts with aluminium to form Mn plus Al2O3. This is one more example. Okay, ma. So Fe2O3 reacts with aluminium to form iron and Al2O3. Clear, ma? SiO2 plus aluminium, they react to form Si plus Al2O3. Okay. So these are the metals which can be reduced with the help of smelting with the help of aluminium, which is also called as Goldsmith thermo-aluminate process. Are you able to understand? That's it. Make a note.